channel. Today I'm going to be bringing you my review and demo of the BH Cosmetics collab with ShanXO here on YouTube. If you guys don't follow her, you totally should. She does amazing makeup and she is super sweet and has an amazing accent that you just want to listen to all day long. So definitely check her out if you haven't. I'm sure you have. But this palette is really, really cool because on one side there are 9 eyeshadows and you get a mirror, and then on the other side you get 9 lipsticks and a mirror. This is really unique. I don't own any palettes that are double-sided like this, and for the price, I mean, I paid $14.50 for this. That is like an amazing price. I do have a demo using both the eyeshadows and the lipsticks, which will be after my review. And I've been using this palette all week. I got it last Saturday when we got back. Not last Saturday. When we get home from vacation. We got home Monday from vacation. And I got it on Monday. And I've been using it ever since. So I've used it Tuesday through today. And I really like the palette so far. The only thing I wish is that maybe there was maybe another transition shade between these two that was a little bit more brown. Because I don't always like to use this orange shade when I am doing my looks, but I did use it today and I have been using it all week, and really the looks have come out really nice. I just have to be careful with what I wear with it because I like to wear a lot of grays and blacks, a lot of cool tone colors, so I was kind of hoping for that middle transition shade. But if you are a warm person, this is perfect palette for you. As far as the lasting power, I haven't had any problems with it lasting throughout my total workday. I have tried it alone, like I will show you today, without any cream base, just my concealer primer, and I haven't had any problems. But if you do want to pick up the pigment a little bit more on the shimmer colors, I do recommend putting like a base underneath. That was the best makeup I got out of it, is when I put a NYX crayon, like the ice jumbo eye stick crayons, underneath the shimmer eyeshadow, and it made it really, really pop. Or of course you could use Fix Plus or anything like that. But other than that, I really, really enjoy this palette. I have used all of the shades now. I did not use all of them in this demo, but I have used them all now this week. The only thing I haven't used everything of are the lipstick shades, just because I haven't had a chance. I don't want to wear like a bright purple or bright pink or orange to work. I would like to stick to the more neutral pinks, and I did use a brighter pink in this tutorial today, but I did end up going back and muting it out just a little bit because I felt it was a little too bright for the eye look. Okay, so here is the box that the palette comes in. It's just, it matches the packaging, the pink with the white, kind of their circles. Looks kind of like clouds or bubbles when you look at it, and then it has a little note on the back that explains the palette and how they came up with it. So yeah, let me go ahead and get into these swatches. Start with the eyeshadow. And these aren't like super, super creamy if you were looking for a super creamy eyeshadow, but they do perform nicely. I've had very minimal fallout. I haven't had hardly any fallout. So that's the top 3 shades. Looks like a fall harvest right there. This shade right here is like a duochrome. It does go green or brown. I saw where Shannon had, she showed a video, I think it was on Snapchat, where she did, or it was maybe one of her vlogs, I can't really remember, but she did different primers under here, and if you use like a black primer, it was green. If you use like a neutral primer, it was more brown, and then a green primer was more green as well. So that's pretty cool that gives you that duochrome shade in there. As far as the mattes go, this is matte, the creamy shade here, the orange shade is a matte, and then this reddish brown shade is a matte. Everything else has a little bit of shimmer or like a satin finish, because like this is almost a matte, but it does have a little bit of satin in it. But yeah, that is it for the eyeshadow side. Okay, so moving on to the lipsticks. Okay, so here are the lipstick swatches. It coincides with the palette. The lipsticks are nice. They all have like great pigment. You can see it here. I did apply these with a lip brush, the same lip brush I'll be using in the video. But they all have nice pigment. As far as the lasting power, I haven't really noticed that it, you know, it hasn't lasted, because at work, you know, I'm not really worried about my lipstick lasting. But if when I go to the bathroom at lunch to get my lunch and stuff, I still have lipstick on, which is great. But yeah, that is my little review of the palette. If you guys have any more questions, let me know down below. Let me know your thoughts on it as well. And yeah, so please stay tuned for the demo. I hope that you guys enjoy this video. Please hit it with a thumbs up. Subscribe if you haven't. Follow me on Snapchat, Twitter, and Instagram, all at TanyaMarie715. And I'll see you guys very, very soon. Vanilla shade in the palette on a fluffy eyeshadow brush, and I'm just putting that all over the lid to set the eyeshadow primer that we put down. Next, I am taking the matte orange shade on a Morphe E23 brush, and I'm just putting that all over the crease from the upper to lower as a transition shade for the eyeshadow. Blending that out into the outer V area, down onto the lid slightly. Lash line.
darkest shade in a flat definer brush, and I am running that from the outer corner onto the center of the lower lash line just to give it some depth and dimension. And then now I'm taking the lightest shimmer highlight shade, and I am highlighting my inner corners with that same up and up eyeshadow brush. Going to do a normal line. I'm not going to wing it out or anything like that. First, I am going to go ahead and curl my lashes. I know it looks so creepy on camera. I'll try to hurry through it. And then I am going in with the Jordana Best Lash Extreme Volumizing Mascara, and I'm just going to put a couple coats on my top and bottom lashes. Lips as well, but you could totally leave the bright shade if you want to.